situation look like. I don't care what you have on your check. I don't care how much your rent is. I don't care how much your bills is. God said, I will never see you forsaken. Now, you might have to go through some things until you move, amen, from promise to prosperity. But he said, if any man, woman, boy, girl, child, amen, will follow me, you got to deny yourself. You know the problem with you is? The problem is you. If you can just get out of the way. No, it ain't your neighbor. It ain't your job. The problem is you. You are in your own way. Oh, I wish I had some people know just what I'm talking about. He said, get out of the way. Get out of the way and let God do it. Is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? He said, let him. He speaks in a masculine sense, but I can say, let her. Or let them. Let them, amen, deny themselves, take up his cross. Tell your neighbor, say, all of us, we got a cross. All of us got a situation. Everybody got a story. Tell your neighbor, say, well, God, at the end of the story, if you follow him, he'll get the glory. Oh, I ain't gonna get nobody here to know what I'm talking about. And glory is not a praise. Glory is not how you feel. Glory is the anointing of God that he will give to you to deal with your situations and the demons that you got to face every day. Oh, look at your neighbor. It's a neighbor. You got demons all around you trying to steal your glory. Amen. But when you follow God, hallelujah, when you deny yourself, he said, I will fight your battle. He said, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. And anybody that fights you is fighting God. Oh, I wish I had some people in here today. Amen. Say, you don't want to mess with me. Amen. Because if you fight me, I got an invisible partner in the ring. Amen. That you don't see. Amen. That will knock you out and knock you upside your head. Because I'm God's anointed. God's anointing. And many of you can't keep getting defeated in your life because you don't have a good self-image of yourself and the God that you serve. Oh, I wish I had somebody in here that know just what I'm talking about. Amen. And that denial is going to hurt. Amen. And that denial, you're going to have to lose some friends. I know you like little Cootie Woody. Amen. I know you like little Shirley. Amen. And one leg Jimmy. Amen. But you got to let them go. Amen. If you go get this glory. Amen. All that God is talking about. Lord, I know they're your friends. Amen. But they don't mean you no good. Amen. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, you're going to have to get some new friends. Hallelujah, yeah. Because them old ones that you hanging out with, they don't mean you no good. The only time they want to be with you is when you buy. I wish I had some people in here. The only time they want to be with you is when they can get a free drink. The only time they want to call you is on Thursday because they know you're getting ready to get paid on Friday. They don't call you no other time, amen, but except payday. They even know when your payday is when you don't even know it. They know it. They stop calling. You ain't heard from me 2 weeks. Amen. But soon as the first, amen, about to get here, around about the 29th, they start calling you, child, what you doing? You want to hang out, and they ain't got no money, but they know, amen, that you gonna buy. Amen. And Jesus said, you got to deny yourself, amen, and follow me. I have some people here know what I'm talking about. Deny. To not deny you. To forsake you. You are the problem. Anytime there's a problem in the church, it starts with me. And sometimes even as leaders, amen, we don't want to accept our fault. We want to blame everybody else. If there's a mess in your house, go home and fix it. Stop blaming on everybody else. Go home and fix it. Folk for something that you need to take control of and take authority. You got to rise up and take the authority back from the enemy.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. Take up your cross and follow me.
That's right.
Then he goes on to say, whosoever will. That's a clarion call. He said, whosoever will, because he know that some people ain't going. So he just saw a blanket net out of there and said, whosoever will, amen, glory to God, is going to save his life. He got to lose it. And see, the problem is you don't want to give up your old life to get a new life. No. You want to parade up in here like you really want God. Amen. But when God is requiring something of you, you don't really want God. You just want it part-time. And God said, I don't need no part-time people. I need full-time followers who are going to love me in the church, out of the church. I don't need no drive-by saint. That's the problem. You keep driving by and you only want God when you're in trouble and you only want God to get you out. Baby, you ain't coming out until God get out of you what's got to come out of you so he can get to you. This ain't no club. This ain't the Easter Stars or the Masons or whatever. This ain't none of that. This ain't no place to hang out. We got real issues up in this camp. We got children in jail. We got bills we got to pay. Come on, we got people on alcohol, people on drugs, people got sex problems, people have too much sex when they don't want to have sex, people shacking up, people doing all that. And then you want to come up in here and think God gonna bless you. God ain't gonna bless you because you haven't denied yourself. I'm preaching the real gospel again.
Yes, you
are. I ain't preaching the gossip. I'm preaching the gospel. If you want to hear the gossip, go to them other churches. But if you want to hear the gospel, you come here. Because we don't preach the gospel because it is the gospel that will liberate your life. And I found out of this. When you raise the standard, those who want it will rise to it. And your neighbor said, I ain't making no more excuses for myself. I had an encounter with God. God said, we're going to do this thing my way or we ain't going to do it at all.
Amen.
Point number one, you got to come to Bible study because you don't know enough. You got to give God some Wednesday time in Bible study. I don't care how far you live. When there was a good party, it could be in another state. You was going there. Some of us live right around the corner talking about we too busy. We too busy for church. We can't go down here. We got this and we got that on our schedule. And that's why you can't get your breakthrough, because you got too much stuff on your schedule, except you don't have God on your schedule. And God want to get on your schedule. God should be the first one on your schedule. And everything else you do should be built around God. Oh, but you too busy.
Preach.
Amen.
I wish I had some people here know what I'm talking about. Yeah. Uh-huh. He said, listen, he said, whosoever will lose, will save his life, shall lose his life, right? I got to lose my life. Amen. But whosoever shall lose his life, he said, for my sake. He said, for my sake. He said, you're doing it for me. Come on, say, man, if you do anything right here for other people, you're going to quit. Why? Because people are going to change on you. Amen. If you're working in the church for your name to be called, stop working. Amen. Because a lot of times, they're not going to call your name. Sometimes you're not going to feel appreciated. But when you know you're working for God, amen. He said, deny yourself for me. Not for your mother. Not for your girlfriend. Not because somebody making you come to church. He said, you got to do this thing for me. Not because you're going to lose your marriage, lose your house, whatever. He said, do it for me. He said, I'll give you another house. He said, I'll give you another marriage. He said, I'll give you another wife. I'll give you what you want. He said, if you deny yourself, he said, I'll do it for you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
My preacher was good stuff.
That's right. For the Lord.
Yes. Three days, I'm not playing with you
now.
I ain't playing with you no more. I ain't got no time for that foolishness.
I know that's right. Amen.
Before we arrive, you got to tell next time. Look, what you need? You need to get saved. I keep telling you the same thing what to do, and next week you coming back with the same problem, and then you got two more problems to add left. You are wearing me out, and you haven't done the first thing I told you to do. Now call me back when we can pray.
Amen.
that's hard. But when you pacify people, they never get right. But it's time to get the pacifier out of your mouth and get off the bottle and start eating some sound food so you can grow.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
You're 3 years old and you still got pampers on. You're scared of everything. You're still wetting in the bed. Come out with anybody.
Glory, Pastor.
Grow up. This army is for tough people. This ain't for no weakness. Your problem's not going to go away because you come up in here. Your problem just might get worse. But at least you'll have something in the toolbox to fight. When the devil comes, you can pull a hammer out and kind of hit the devil upside his head. Amen. But if you don't got nothing in the toolbox, amen, when the devil comes, he just take everything that you got. Take the joy. Take your peace. Keep you depressed. You can't even get out of bed. You're so stressed. You're on 2 blood pressure medicines now.
My God.
Yes. Yes. Come on, baby. Yes. Every time you turn around, go to the doctor, something wrong with me. Yes, something is wrong with you. You won't surrender your life to God.
Amen.
I think something wrong with me. I need you to write me another prescription. God already wrote a prescription for you, baby.
Amen.
Some people do need some medicine, though, for real. Seriously.
Amen.
I'm going to start taking medicine. Amen. Don't get that. Take it. I'm going to say amen.
Amen.
Listen. And then he says this. He said, verse 36 says, so he says, so what profit? Y'all know what profit is, right? In any business, they have what is called a profit and loss figure, right? So at the end of the day, amen, if the business ain't making no money, then it ain't profiting, right? Amen. God has a profit and loss statement. He writes. You can't see it, but he's writing all the time on the profit and loss statement. This one has denied me. This one has accepted me. This one is playing. This one is thinking I'm playing with them, but I am not playing with them. On the profit and loss statement. So he says, what does it profit me if I gain the whole world? Prince, 57 years old, $300 million left. That he never get a chance to enjoy.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
The woman out there, he probably had AIDS. Y'all heard that one, right?
Yes.
The toxicology report would be back and said that they found opiates on him when he died.
Mm-hmm.
Now he had the whole world.
Because
yes. That's what the devil make you believe, that you want to be in purple rain. Y'all know purple rain, right?
Yes.
Man, that's almost something. I'm saying, I wouldn't say anything. Prince died, they fled to the streets, amen, they played a song, and all of that. If Jesus was coming back, them Negroes wouldn't have been nowhere. Some of y'all was on there falling all over Prince. Y'all ain't getting none of Prince money. Come on, say amen. Y'all play the track. Oh, Prince gotta see God. Y'all know that, right? Yeah, he got to see God. Come on. All of those millions can't help him. Come on, say amen. They said Prince had a compound where he ain't let nobody in. He had his own estate.